This is the Mighty Z of Capital Chaos TV. We're hanging out here with Michael of Dark Tranquility. How's it going, Michael?
It's going great, man. Enjoying the hell out of this.
It's a pretty nice San Francisco night, eh?
It's beautiful. We've been way up north. We just came from Canada a couple of days ago, and it's been freezing cold. Shut down roads, all that crap. So now finally we're on the right track coming down south.
Now, I would imagine you've been here to San Francisco many times before.
Yeah. This is our fifth, sixth time, something like that. But it's always great. Love it here.
And tonight you're headlining with Omnium Gatherum and Ex Mortis.
Yes. Yeah, they've been with us the entire tour. So Ex Mortis are from LA area, I think, and Omnium Gatherum are from Finland, and we've toured many times together, and we're really good friends, so we figured we'd bring them over here, you know, when we do a tour, and this is their first time in America ever, so they've been little giddy touristy boys today.
Oh, nice. And are you familiar enough with America that you can take them to the sites?
Oh, yeah, I guess I can, but they have friends who do that for them as well, but tomorrow I'll be show them around Las Vegas, where we're going next. So that's nice. Going to be awesome.
And have you gotten an opportunity to hang out with Ex Mortis as well and do some drinking or whatever other activities one might engage in?
Yeah, we bring those little kids over to our bus sometimes and show them what it's like to be on a proper tour and what you're supposed to do. This is their first ever proper tour, so we swap tour stories and teach them to drink properly like Scandinavians.
Nice. Are they learning to hold their liquor?
Some of them are, yeah. They're getting better, but they still don't stand a chance.
What are some of the secrets to maintaining that high tolerance to beer that you apparently have?
Oh, years of experience, of course, but now I guess, like, I find it kind of difficult because I'm into a lot of microbrews. I love, like, trying new stuff. And some of it's pretty damn strong, so I'll try to take it easy with that. You know, you like spend the day drinking something regular, you know, mild, and then after the show I celebrate, you know, with something strong and good and tasty and stouty or IPAs and stuff
like that. So. Are those kind of beers, microbrews, ales in particular, are they popular where you come from?
They actually are. There's like a big kind of microbrew revolution going on in Sweden as well. So. So it was the first time I came here, I kind of learned about all these really, really cool beers, and now you can never find them in Sweden, you know, 10 years ago. But now it's a totally different story. Now I even privately import a lot of stuff from here. So, but there's still tons of stuff that you cannot get. So it's, every day is like a discovery mission, like going to liquor stores and beer stores and finding new stuff.
You know? Right.
I love that.
Do you like wine and liquor as well, or just beer?
No, I'm a beer and whiskey guy, you know. So I got some good whiskeys today, so I'm pretty happy about that as well. But.
So once again, you're on tour with Omnium Gatherum, Ex Mortis, and No Basis, that's right?
Yeah. We figure, like, we've been kind of struggling with Basis for a while, and then we struggled with this album a lot, so we figure, like, we don't want to bring anyone in new, you know, into the band. We just focus on the five of us right now and just kind of make that work, you know? So Martin recorded bass before we left, so we have like a bass track that runs through the entire show, which sounds actually awesome, but it does feel weird, but this was the kind of the solution that we came to. We couldn't figure out anything else out.
And you may be, many bands are using drum machines, from Fear Factory to maybe Linkin Park.
Yeah.
You're not the first to use a bass track.
No, I guess not. Yeah, no, anything is possible. Like you can switch out anyone, you know, and just do a track, I guess. But it is, you know, it's a kind of emergency solution, I guess.
It's probably difficult to jam then, right?
Oh, yeah. But we don't really do that. We're not really a jam band. We have everything pretty much in order, and everything has to be perfect and tight. And we do, since we time all of our video projections and stuff like that as well with the music. So it has to be there. It has to be on time.
And you said 25 years of Dark Tranquility, is that right?
Yeah, coming up on it, yeah. Weird.
Yeah, time flies. And that's 10 albums. Number 10 is the most recent one, correct?
Yes. It. I mean, when I think about it or when I hear someone else say it, I go like, holy shit, really? But at the same time, I don't really think about it. It's been such a great ride, and of course this is something that we've been doing more than half our lives. You know, we were 14, 15 when we started the band. And this became everything immediately, almost. You know, you just you start the band, and then anything else kind of fades away into the background. You go like, I don't want to do anything else. This is it. I want to be in the rehearsal room all the day. I want to write and play and scream and all that stuff. So, and then I guess time just flew by, yep. You know.
And finally, do you have anything that you'd like to say to anybody that might be watching this on Capital Chaos TV?
We're just super excited to be back here, and it's been an awesome tour so far. We have a few more dates to go, and it's been fantastic. So thank you all for showing up and showing support. Love it.